You. And happy Sabbath, everyone. Welcome to another episode of Adventist Youth Live. We are very happy that you can join us this evening for this episode. And I'm telling you, it's going to be an interesting episode this evening. Well, let me take the opportunity to welcome our guests tonight, our smiling faces, beautiful faces, and one handsome face.
Oh, yeah.
Well, you know, with us tonight, you know, a group of young people again. Youth Life is all about, you know, using our young people as far as possible, together with some resource persons, to reach other young people and to minister to young people throughout the Grenada Conference of Seventh-day Adventists and throughout the Caribbean, throughout the world. And of course, we're very happy that we can have a bunch of young people in studio with us tonight, right? Tonight we have Sarana Phillips. She's no stranger to this place, you know? And then we have Pastor Lambert Paul, yeah? Lambert Paul, you have seen him before, and you will continue to see him on this program. And I think joining us for the very first time on Adventist Youth Live is a young lady that you might have heard of. Maybe you have seen her sometime, but of course, she's with us tonight, and her name is Ludin Bess. Sister Bess, welcome. And welcome tonight, you know.
Thank you. Happy Sabbath to you.
How was the week? How things, you know, has been?
Well, the week was rough, you know. Sometimes you have some rough days, but I made it by God's grace.
You made it by God's grace.
Yes, right. I did.
Lambert, what about you?
Well, you know, I had a good week, and always look forward to the Sabbath.
All right, very
Sabbath
nice.
Is a time when you can rest and feel refreshed. So yeah. It was wonderful, and I'm happy for the Sabbath. Mm-hmm. And happy to be here tonight.
You look that way, man. What about you?
Well, I had a good week up until Thursday, where we had a tsunami simulation.
Oh.
And I had to run for my life faster.
Really?
Trust me, that thing was coming.
Wow.
It was going to get to me. But apart from that, you know, it was okay.
God is good. We trust God. You know? Well, thank you very much. And folks, we welcome you. And before we go any further, all we want you to do is to like and share this page. Remember, that's our tagline around here. Because you are an integral part of this ministry. And so we want you to like and to share the page. Yeah? So just take a few seconds. It's not long. You're right there already. You're viewing. Take a few seconds and like and share. So all your friends around the world, around Grenada, all the young people, especially all young people, you know, because these topics are specially tailored for them. So we want you to like and share the page and invite your friends to view Adventist Youth Live. But before we go any further, let's pause as we say a word of prayer. Pastor Lambert, pray and ask God to guide us through this episode tonight.
All right, let us pray. Almighty God, loving Father, we come before you tonight in the name of Jesus. We give you thanks and praise, O God, and we thank you for another opportunity to be here. We pray, dear God, that you will come on us, you will grant us power, grant us authority, grant us boldness, dear God. Mm-hmm. And we pray that you will bring the hearts of those who are viewing, dear God, so they can be touched and they can feel the power of your Holy Spirit in their lives.
Yes.
We thank you, O God. May you take charge of everything that will be done and said here tonight, I ask, in Jesus' name.
Amen. 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 All right, so we have some of our viewers already online, and I like to interact because that's why they are there.
Yes,
right.
Yes.
So I like to interact with them. So before we go into the praise and worship, let's see who we have just joining us and just hailing them out and so on, you know. Who we have, Lambert, who we have there?
All right, Ruth Pursue saying happy Sabbath. Sally Mara saying happy Sabbath.
Mm-hmm.
Nathan Best, join us.
Oh, Nathan, how you doing?
Yes, man. Yes.
Good, good, yeah.
All right.
Francesca Pep. Poppy, yeah.
Happy Sabbath.
Vicky's there, very nice. Yeah, who else you see there?
Sally Maras.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. Roslyn Jeffers. Right, and they're coming, right? So Michael Kimo is there.
Yes.
Good to have you, Michael.
Yes,
yeah, Catherine Isidore is out there. That person must be related to Pastor Isidore in some kind of form or way, you know?
Yes.
But we're very happy that you can join us. Very, very nice. Mm-hmm. Danny Joseph is there. Sarana Philippe is there. Who's that boy? Yeah. And so on, Indra Thomas, that name sounds familiar, you know.
Yes.
Oh, we're very happy to have you.
Yes.
Delisa George is there, Gary Harris is there, Kish Cornwall is there, Francis Hamlet is there, Rhonda Cornwall, and they're coming.
Yes, man.
So remember to like the page and to share the page. It's Adventist Youth Live, and we have a very interesting episode for you tonight. But let's take a break. Let's sing.
Mm-hmm.
Let's sing. You ready to sing?
Oh, yes. Oh, yes.
Right. Well, let's leave it up, man, and let's sing to the honor and glory of God. What's our first number tonight?
All right, our first number is 442 and it's coming from Kasha.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, Kasha. 442.
Right. 442. Remember, we sing the first and
how
the last.
How sweet are the tidings.
Right. First and last stanzas, so at least as many persons as possible can get an opportunity
yes.
to hear
yes.
their number. Right? 442.
Yes.
Beautiful hymn indeed, you know. What's the next number, Ludin? We have another person. What's the next number?
We have Indra Thomas, 449. 449.
449. Boy, I know a lot of people love this hymn. Eh?
Oh, yes, oh, yes.
449.
Never part
again. Let's join and sing. And remember, while we sing, you know, you can just use your finger and just like and share the page. Let everybody join. It's a family affair as we join and praise the name of the Lord on this
Amen.
Wonderful Sabbath evening. Amen.
Excuse the night and pleasures by night.
up, you know. next time. Remember to like and share the page, right? Like and share the page. Good so far, good so far.
Yes,
Lambert, what's
yes.
the next number we have?
All right, the next number we have is 336 by Francisca.
Oh,
all right.
Francisca, 336.
Mm-hmm.
And that's not like a new hymn, boy.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, there's
a
fountain.
Okay.
Every communion we sing in
yes.
that.
Yeah, yeah. Stanzas 1 and 6, yeah?
Yes.
Stanzas 1 and 6 tonight.
That next song is my favorite song.
Your favorite song?
Yes, one of my favorite songs.
Mm-hmm.
632, Until Then.
You
and
it's your favorite too?
One of my favorites.
One of your favorites, all right. Nice.
And Francis Hamlet wants us to sing that song.
Well, let's sing it.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Join us, Francis,
yes.
as we sing 632.
Borrowed for a while.
really setting the pace for what we're talking about tonight. And maybe I could just tell you something tonight. You got to stay because Jesus is on the main line.
Oh, yes. Oh, yes.
Yes.
I tell you, that's what we're talking about. But hold your seat, right? You're going to hear much more. We have some testimonies coming. They're going to blow. Come on, man. I'm telling you. Let's continue to see you here. Ludini, who's the next expo? Who's the next? What's
we
the next number?
Rhonda Conwell.
Rhonda, right.
This is my favorite song. 100.
So you have plenty of favorites, man.
The best.
Right. 100.
That's
100. Right, let's sing with Rhonda and all. Remember to like the page and to share the page, yeah? And to invite everybody in this moment of praise and worship to Almighty God on His holy Sabbath day. Yeah, let's sing 100. From just singing with them, but we want to shout out a few. Come, Ludin, tell us who you see there now, man. Shout them out.
Okay, I see Roger Isaac, and this person is saying Happy Sabbath.
Very nice.
Sabbath to you as
Very
well.
Very nice. Happy Sabbath, my friend. Continue.
Janelle Grant, Grant Hamlet, Happy Sabbath.
Very nice.
Michelle Kimo,
Michael.
Yes. Happy Sabbath to you, Telson Sandy. And he's from. The West, right?
West, yes.
Pastor Jamie God, is that
Jamie God?
Is that Pastor? Happy Sabbath.
Yes.
All right.
Rosalind Jeffers McCoy.
Happy Sabbath to you as well.
Yes.
Right. Mm-hmm.
Come on, let's go. Let's go. Indra Thomas is there. Shadina Scott.
Happy Sabbath
to you.
Shomin Bihari.
Shomin from my church. Happy Sabbath to you, Shomin.
A fella by the name of Kindo. He goes by
King
that
Dory.
Name.
Kindori.
All right,
we have Beverly.
Mm-hmm.
We have Rosalind,
yeah.
You see that one already. Marlene McDonald.
McDonald, yeah.
Say good night, Pastor Hillary and Sister Bess.
All right, good.
All right, and Mary James.
Oh, Marlene, my good friend.
Marlene,
hold on. What I want you to do for me? Marlene, man, listen. You have a wide spectrum. Come on, just like that page and share that page for me tonight, Marlene. I'm not going to let you get away with that tonight, right? So like the page and share the page, you know, that kind of thing, yeah? And Mary, and James, you do the same. Same thing too, yeah. Like that page and share that page, all right?
Oh, yeah.
Very nice. Mary Neb is there. Best media is
there. Say good night to everyone from Cuba. Special good night to Aunt Bess and Pastor Healy. I hope y'all don't miss me much and Cam this year.
We miss you, boy.
Donnie George, join us. Happy Sabbath, Donnie. Welcome.
Heavenly Maury is there. Very nice. Joel Johnson is there. Happy Sabbath, guys.
Yes.
Always a blessing to behold another Sabbath day of rest and gladness.
Amen, amen.
And
amen.
Of course, the list goes on. But let's break again. Let's take another hymn. Yeah, let's see how we're doing on time. Maybe we might be able to take just about two more or so.
Mm-hmm.
But let's see what the producers say. Yeah? Mm-hmm. But I'm sure we could take one more.
Yeah.
We could take
one
more.
I call the next song. You know,
you're fine?
Yes. Yes.
Right.
Yes.
Oh, 264. And for Daniel Philip, my good friend. Daniel, we're glad to have you. Daniel, like the page and share the page. Yeah. Right. That's how we do it on Adventist Youth Live, coming to you from the Grenada Conference of Seventh-day Adventists, 264.
Chama Hamlet, and hymn one. Praise to the Lord.
Hymn number one. Praise to the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, praise to the Lord. But I tell you, boy, time flies when you're having fun
in
the Lord.
Yes,
eh?
Yes.
You know, in the presence of the Lord, there's joy and pleasures forevermore and that kind of, you know, it's good to be in the presence of the Lord. Yeah. Hymn number one, as we sing with Chima Hamlet. Producer nodding, so I like that.
Who do we have?
Let's see if we can get one there.
We have Dennis George, and she's requesting hymn number 439.
439. Thank you, Dennis. Remember to like and share the page. Yeah, you'll hear me saying that over and over because this ministry is so important and so critical. People have been blessed all over Grenada, all over the Caribbean, all over the world. And you are viewing your comments, your suggestions, you know. You are an integral part of this ministry. And by liking and sharing, hello, you just will be blessing somebody. You're just saving a life. You're just helping somebody to get victory and power and so on from Almighty God. So remember to like and share, yeah? like and share, and call up your friends, tell them Youth Life, Adventist Youth Life is on. They must like and share also.
Oh, yeah.
And
yes.
You know, like everybody must know about this program and be part of this program tonight.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah? 439 as we sing together.
Tonight you'll sing Anderson Joseph, and the hymn he requests is 384.
384.
Yeah.
384. Let's join to sing this last one together. Whatever you're doing, wherever you are, you know, let's put our all into this last one tonight. 384.
Yes, safely through another week.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
And you seem to be enjoying it.
I'm enjoying your singing, Pastor.
You're my singer?
Oh, yes.
Well, you know, everybody knows that I can, you know. But, you know, we do this thing together. It's a beautiful wonderful opportunity that we have to worship God together on Adventist Youth Live. Yeah? Well, let's hear what is happening. Thank you very much. You know, stay tuned. Tonight we are discussing a very important topic. Jesus on the main line. Jesus on the main line, yeah? And I just want to throw it out, you know. Guess what we are talking about. I mean, if anybody can guess correctly, I might just give you a nice broad smile, you know, or something. You know, but Jesus on the main line. But before we get there, to what actually we're talking about this evening. We want to bring to you and maybe interact with some of our online viewers and then bring to you some happenings, some promotions. Yeah. So Dalisha Henry is there. She says, good night, Youth Life family. Good night, Dalisha.
Good night.
Who else we have, Sarana? Who else we have there?
We have is Lovon.
Yes.
Yeah, Lovon. Happy Sabbath to you. Rhonda Cornwall.
Yes, very nice.
Tyrone,
Isaac,
just joined.
Good to see you, man.
And then we have Richard
yes.
from the Philippines.
Hey, Richard from the Philippines.
Uh-huh.
Richard Romero Federal. Boy, I wonder that Richard. Boy, Richard, Richard is Richard. You went to USC? Just answer yes. You know, you look like the guy. You sound like the guy. You know, the name, but you know, Richard boy. If that Richard, you remember some good things, yeah. Then we have Kimberly Philip.
Yeah.
Who else do we have? Yeah. Yeah,
oh, sorry, Donis. Next time we'll sing your song.
Yeah. we have Adriel Isaac is there. Very nice. Sylvanos Seal Thomas is there. I tell you, Brent Strong is there. Mm-hmm. Who else we have there?
Thomas
Baptiste is there. Colin Modest.
Yeah.
Yes,
Angel Joseph
there.
Is there.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, very nice. Maureen Dotting. Ronda. Boy, we
Ronda
just love all of
yes.
all of them say
happy
Sabbath.
Anderson Joseph, Richard Neckers.
Mm-hmm. Richard Neckers is there too.
Yes, man.
Yeah,
hey, good night, happy Sabbath.
Hold. Boy, so many people.
You have Molly
Nancy. Molly, she will like very nice. But I want you to like the page and too. Share the page. Look, we have somebody
from
Canada.
You know.
Big
yes.
up that box.
That's my family, man. That's my
family.
That's my
family.
Right, man. So Shawnee and Jason, well, she using Kimberly on Facebook, but Shawnee and Jason and Jace.
Right.
Happy Sabbath and nice to have you all on Youth Life tonight.
Right.
Right.
Say, yeah, man. I love all you. You know, Jesus.
Somebody
name.
From St. Lucia, Pastor.
Somebody from St. Lucia.
Yes.
We'll beat them up again now.
Bibiana. Yes. Welcome.
What she says,
happy
what
Sabbath.
She says, yeah.
Happy Sabbath from St. Lucia.
From St. Lucia, the
yes.
Helen of the West.
Yes.
Is right up there. Very nice. Very nice. Carol. Look, Carol Brandon.
Okay.
Boy, Caroline Brandon, I think she's a pastor from Guyana.
Yes.
She's a pastor friend from Guyana. Carol, girl, and I hear you're going in good stuff just now, you know. Carol, we're glad to have you on Adventist Youth Live, yeah? All right, very, very nice. Who else? We have Lena Gilbert is there.
Yes.
And, oh boy, the list is going. Boy, let me go to some promotion. We'll come back to all you just now because they keep coming. But I like to interact with my
yeah,
life.
Yeah, yeah, yeah,
yeah. Interact,
yeah.
Make them happy because
of
you
course.
Are an integral part of this Adventist Youth Life family.
Right,
believe
right,
it or not,
right.
You are. Right, well, let's see what's happening around the conference, you know. We have a number of evangelistic outreach programs that are geared to build families and develop communities and keep our nation sweet and nice. And right now, even as we speak tonight in St. David's, Pastor Johnson Frederick, the Executive Secretary of the Caribbean Union Conference, is out there and preaching the gospel, yeah, because we
Amen.
Believe
right.
and a whole host of young people, the entire district as a matter of fact, and a whole host of young people are surrounding him, you know, praying for him, doing the bits and so on.
Yeah.
So if you are around that area, maybe after we finish, well, they might be finished by then, but tomorrow, God's willing, and for the rest of the week coming up, you need to visit and, you know, and support, bring along a friend and enjoy good gospel service night after night, yeah. And then, of course, coming up, Henry Sajan will start in River Sally Church on Sunday. He will be there starting. You know, Henry Sajan is a guy, he's a man of God.
Yes, man. A whole soul, that's it.
I like how you put it.
A whole soul,
yeah. Yeah, he'll be out in River Sally. They're starting from Sunday, 7 p.m., yeah? He will be there. Go out there and hear this man of God. And he's a singing evangelist too.
Yeah.
I love to hear this man,
yes,
you know, preach the word of God, yeah? And not only that, but we have something happening, very special happening on the 30th of March. I'm coming up at the St. George's University. They'll be having church on campus, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
Church on campus, all the Adventist students. Young people, you know,
yes,
man?
Yes.
Young people, but they're on fire for Jesus.
Oh, yes.
All
oh,
the
yes.
university
yes.
down there, yeah? And Pastor Jamie Gordon is keeping them happy, you know?
Yes.
And sometimes I smile at them too, you know? But of course, we have a good thing going down there, and we keep them happy. They travel from all over the world, all over the Caribbean, to come to study at St. George's University. And of course, they have a group in there. We service them. We be with them. So the annual church on campus, you know, it's a big thing. And we want to make sure that you attend and you support them in whatever way possible. Yeah, we're very happy for your support and your contribution. Also coming in Montrose, Montrose Seventh-day Adventist Church is the Better Living Health Seminar. Better Living Health Seminar. You know, anybody close to Montrose? Yeah, yeah. Ludin, you might be closer to Montrose, you know. Make sure that you go, Ludin, yeah. It will be able. Let me tell you the date it's starting. It's starting on March 24th.
Okay.
March 24th, you know, and run for a few days. So you can't miss the opening night. Just go for the opening night,
okay,
and they'll tell you more by the grace of God, all right?
All right.
Then, of course, tomorrow is a big
yes,
thing
man,
to all the greater conference.
Yes,
tomorrow, why you are chair?
Hey,
I want to get up and leave already.
Yeah.
You know, tomorrow, tell us about something.
Well,
about tomorrow,
well, tomorrow what is happening is Global Youth Day.
Global,
so,
yeah.
What
so,
is that?
So all the young people from all the Adventist churches around the island of Grenada, Carico, Pity, Matnik, will be going into the communities, going into homes, giving food basket, praying, preaching. Plenty things will be happening tomorrow.
Yes.
So I'm telling you, look out for them. Welcome them with a big smile.
Yes.
Give them some of your time. And at the end, when they leave your home, you will be blessed. It'll be a grand time tomorrow on the island of Grenada, Carico, Pity, Matnik.
Boy, I feel your vibes.
Yes,
man.
Yes, man.
And the theme is Adopt. And it's a world church program.
Yeah.
Venice young people leading that charge there and so on. They are going to be someone to their life. And they are going to adopt a home, an orphan, an elderly, you know, and so on. And they're going to be having a wonderful time. And also, not only that, but in the morning that's going to happen. So a number of churches is going to be closed for the morning. You're going to be joining them. But they're going to come back in the afternoon for the youth, the beginning of the Youth Week of Prayer. The Youth Week of Prayer, where young people, what did I
yes,
say?
Man. Yes,
Youth
man.
Week of Prayer. Young people got to spend time. We have a lot of challenges, a lot of issues and so on. But we got to spend time praying to the Lord. Would you say amen?
Amen, amen, amen.
So the Youth Week of Prayer. So wherever you are, find an Adventist church. And the Youth Week of Prayer begins tomorrow afternoon with special music, nice program, special readings. Young people are going to be doing those things. And then, of course, they're going to have sessions of prayer. Whatever your burdens, whatever your challenges, you're going to bring them to the Lord. Yeah.
Amen.
And not only tomorrow, but it continues for the entire week until next Sabbath. Isn't that wonderful?
Yes.
So you can just
yes.
walk into an Adventist church close to you, you know, at 7 p.m. In Grenada. I mean, those of you looking elsewhere, the time zone might be different. But you know, and so on, and enjoy this special week as our young people, you know, just petition the throne and be revived and get the relief and get the blessing from the Lord. It's Adventist Youth Week of Prayer, And on next Sabbath, the 23rd, is going to be Youth Homecoming.
Yes, man.
I mark it, you know.
In a big way.
In a big way, boy. Some churches have great things, you know, and so on by the grace of God, right? So we want you to make sure. Then my final thing, but I have something here to show them. Where is it, boy? Let me put on some papers and things, you know. I need a desk when I come inside here, you know. I always have things to tell all you, you know. But anyway, you know, look at this beautiful book. Have you ever seen it before, Savannah?
No.
Like the first time you see
it,
you always know I have something new to show you. You know, you see that? Like, you know, the camera could pick it up there, right? Make sure you pick it up. This wonderful book will be coming your way. It's here in the Grenada Conference. It's a missionary book of the year, and it's the book that's going to be distributed throughout the length and breadth of Grenada, the Caribbean, and elsewhere.
Okay.
Yeah. So members of the Seventh-day Adventist Church, it is your responsibility to make sure that you place your order with your church leaders. Yeah. Place your order with your church leaders, and they will tell you how you can get it and other information and so on. And then you're going to be distributing.
Okay.
You're going to be distributing this beautiful book. It's a beautiful. What it says? Hope for today's family.
Yeah.
Wow.
So
we need that. We need that.
Hope for today's family.
Yeah,
so you got to make sure that you start making your orders from tomorrow. Talk to your church elder. Talk to your personal ministries leader, your publishing secretary in your church, you know, and tell them, listen, I want 100 of this book. I want 50 of this book. Don't bother. You know the usual thing. Yeah, not an expensive thing. You know?
Yeah.
A little nice book to place in somebody's hand for the honor and glory of God. Would you say?
Amen.
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 So that's a number of things happening there. You know, anything else happening by you, Lambert? Anything?
No, well, at the end of April, we will be having an evangelistic campaign. We're
right.
Warming up still.
Very nice.
Right, we're warming up. So we'll have it with Maxine Noel.
Maxine,
nice in the closure area.
Yeah.
Right, so we're just warming up still.
Fire
so as
young
we get, as, yes, man. So as we get closer, we will let you know. Last week, he was in our district, and he did a wonderful job in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Yes, man.
Yeah,
so we have grand things coming up.
Praise God. Praise God. Yeah. Right, as we roll, man, young people on fire for Jesus.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, young people on fire for Jesus as we continue to, you know, impact our communities, impact our nation, you know, for good, change lives by the grace of God, would you say, amen.
Amen.
Well, tonight, ladies and gentlemen, we're talking quiz time is coming up in a while, you know, but let's interact again. We have Petty Lalit says, good night, CeeLo Thomas. You're doing a great job. Keep it up. All right. Very nice. But he's not here, but you know. Right. CeeLo says, hi, Sister Drake, Keisha. We're missing your singing. All right. Good. Right. Say, balance as usual. Right. But of course, our topic tonight is Jesus on the main line. You know, just shoot me a little message and tell me what you think we're talking about tonight now before I come to that, right? Jesus on the main line. But we want to go to our quiz tonight, and that might just give you an idea as to what we are talking about, right? Quiz. All right. Quiz. All right. All right, so our quiz now. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to start. I'm going to start with the first question, Sarana. The next one is yours. All right. And so on. So get out your Bible or your phone. All right. I see Teresa Emmons is ready there. Netita Keto is ready there. Jeremiah Diana is prayer. You know, prayer. Somebody says prayer we're talking about. We're going to see if you're correct.
All right.
You know? Nice, boy. I like all you tonight. Right. So the first question. Quiz time. You ready? Ready. Let's go. Shoot the question. Uh-huh. And we go. So let's go. The first question. God spoke to Abimelech.
Mm-hmm.
I have it right. Abimelech, and told him that Abraham would pray for him and he would finish the statement.
All right.
Finish the statement. Yeah. And God spoke to Abimelech and told him that Abraham would pray for him and he would. All right. He would.
We wait in. What's the response?
All right. Nova Null says, is that book available online for those of us outside Grenada who may be interested? I'm not too sure. We could always find out and get back to you, but I'm not too sure at the moment, yeah? Because it has just reached our shows, and I think it's the Inter-American Division, and should be running through a number of the fields, all right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Teresa Emmons says, happy Sabbath from Kariku. Kariku is in the house.
Oh, yeah.
All right, so what's your answer? the first question is on. God spoke to Abimelech and told him that Abraham would pray for him and he would.
We have to give them some clue. Like, nobody make it. They're not even making an attempt.
No. Give them a clue. Give them a clue for me. Give them a clue.
All right, Genesis chapter 20.
Mm-hmm. Genesis 20.
Genesis 20.
All right, so let's see who is coming with it there. Run to Genesis 20 quickly.
All right, while you're going to Genesis 20. All right, Sister Judith and Imran, the Sincere family, they are saying happy Sabbath.
Uh-huh.
Happy Sabbath to y'all there in the U.S.
Yeah,
all right, nice to know that y'all are viewing.
All right.
All right.
But it's quiz time. Genesis chapter 20.
Uh-huh.
Luke 4 to 7. From verse 4 to 7. That looked like a hard one, but
Genesis chapter 20.
Mm-hmm.
And verse 4 to 7.
Right, so God spoke to Abimelech and told him that Abraham would pray for him and he would what?
He would hear.
She must say he would hear. Alright, not quite what we're looking for, but give us something else. Alright, it's quiz time, let's see. Alright, well, give us the answer. Let's take the answer.
Let somebody make a try, man.
You want somebody else?
Yes, man. Yes, man.
What?
Genesis chapter 20, verse 4 to 7.
All right, we're ready to go to question 2.
Yeah.
Because we have to get to our main topic tonight. So you gotta.
He restores Sarah. All right, well, we have to give them the answer. Live. Run negative.
Yeah.
Right, heel.
Ron Wilson.
They wake up now, man. Shall leave. Yes, man. He will leave. Like internet was frozen, man. Heel. Yes, man. Leave, right? That's what I'm talking about.
Okay,
right.
Nice. Next question. Sarah, yours.
Yes,
question 2.
Question 2.
Question 2, we on. So let's go now. You get the momentum.
Yes. Why did Isaac pray to the Lord for his wife, Rebecca?
Mm-hmm. Right. So tell us, you don't even have to go to the Bible for this one. Right?
That's an easy question.
Okay, Sister Cassandra Charles Isadu is there. Very nice. Mm-hmm. Alright, come. Why did Isaac pray to the Lord?
Mm-hmm.
For his wife Rebecca.
Mm-hmm.
What's the answer? Mm-hmm. Right. Agnes Alexander, happy Sabbath viewing from Virgin Godad. Oh, Virgin Godad is in the house. Yeah. Welcome. Welcome. Remember to like and share the page. Mm-hmm. Alright, so what's the answer to this one? We gotta go. Quiz time. Who's coming with the answer?
I believe the internet does freeze, man.
Alright, so give them a clue.
Alright, Pixie, give them a clue.
Okay, this found in Genesis Genesis chapter 25 and verse 21.
Genesis
25, 21.
Adriel said something. He prayed for a child.
Chimahamed said she was barren.
We could still give. We could still give.
Adriel,
right, Papi, she's coming in with it, right? Right,
to have a baby, yes. Okay, let's go on. Number three. What did the priest Eli think when he saw Hannah praying? What did the priest Eli think when he saw Hannah praying?
Yeah, well, I could answer that one.
For Samuel, chapter 1.
They know that one, man. They know that one. All right. What did the priest Eli think? When he saw Hannah praying. Alright. What did he think? Alright. Angel Abraham says.
Okay. Randall said the same
she
thing.
She was drunk.
Rudy Koto said. Julissa said she was drunk. Jeremiah. Okay.
Yes.
Right. So we have it now.
Very nice.
Right.
Very nice.
He thought that she was drunk.
Moving on to question 4.
Yes.
When Elisha prayed for his servant and the Lord opened the eyes of the servant, what did he see? When Elijah prayed for his servant and the Lord opened the eyes of the servant, what did he see?
I think we had to give him a clue one time.
Yes.
And the clue is found in 2 Kings chapter 6 and verse 17.
What, you give them everything?
Yeah.
You know? I like that.
The whole package. Somebody still responding to Eli. She was intoxicated.
Yeah. Okay. That could work too.
Yes, man.
All right. But an army. Somebody saying angel to the question, the last question. We could hold that.
You're close.
Yeah. You're close.
Break it up.
What else?
Anami.
All right. Anami. All right, what else?
Army of angels.
Angels. All right, tell us what you look. Tell us the answer. We could work with that, you know. But, you know, tell us what specific answer you have there.
The mountain was full of horses and chariots of fire all around Elijah.
Oh.
Yeah, look at somebody
with horses and chariots.
Okay.
Mountain filled with horses and chariots of fire.
This is getting
Randall.
Important.
Yes,
you may have about 25 points already.
Yeah, Randall on the ball tonight.
Jason John has joined us. Jason, good night, man.
Good night.
Praying for you tonight.
Yeah.
Right, very nice. Randall is on the ball. Right, let's go. Next one. Who's done? My turn?
Yes, turn.
Number 5. When Elijah had prayed for the child of the Shunammite woman, right, what did he tell his servant to do? When Elisha had prayed for the child of the Shunammite woman, what did he tell his servant to do? You can go to 2 Kings chapter 4. 2 Kings chapter 4 from verse about 8. So, right? Let's go. When Elisha had prayed for the child of the Shunammite woman, what did he tell his servants to do? Right? So let's get this one there. And we see people are making, still answering the previous question. That's nice. Right? Very good coming, giving the very specific answer. But we have a new question on the board now. When Elisha had prayed for the child of the Shunammite woman, what did he tell his servant to do? All right.
Give her something to eat. Lay staff on the child.
You can find in 2 Kings 4, 8 to 12. 8 to 12. Prepare a meal and give him to get first. Give her something to eat. Kibo Cyrus is there. Kibo is on. Go and place his staff on him. All right. You may be right, but what we're looking for is call the Shunammite woman. Yeah? Call the Shunammite woman. You would see that there. You say, tell the servant, call the Shunammite woman.
Yeah,
let's
check on.
All right. Very nice. Right. Number six. Let's go to number six. Listen up, number six now.
What did Elisha pray for the Arameans when they came down against him? What did Elisha pray for the Arameans when they came down against him?
And the clue is 2 Kings chapter 6 and verse 18.
Yes.
Boy, there are some interesting questions tonight, boy.
Yes.
All right. Let's see who is coming with it. You want to repeat it again? Repeat it again.
What did Elijah pray for the Arameans when they came down against him?
What's the clue? What's the clue?
The clue is 2 Kings 6:18.
Mm-hmm. After this Second one, four more to go.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. All right, so tell us.
Okay, Rondell Wilson.
Mm-hmm. What he says, Rondell on the ball.
Smite with blindness. Ball.
Blindness. That is correct. Right.
Blindness,
yes.
All right.
Mm-hmm.
Very
that
nice.
God will strike them with blindness.
Right,
correct.
Very nice. And those of you still responding to the previous question, good. Yeah, very nice.
Mm-hmm.
All right. I guess based on where you are, you have a little delay in the internet and so on, but that's good, right?
Yes.
All right. Still with us. Very nice. Let's go. We
number
have
seven.
Mm-hmm.
All right. What did God do in response as Hezekiah wept to God in prayer?
Mm.
So when Hezekiah started crying to God, what did God do for him?
Yeah, that's an easy one.
Yeah, easy, like 1, 2, 3.
That's
an
easy
ABC.
One.
Yeah.
It's an easy one.
So Hezekiah started to cry to God in prayer and God did something for him.
Right. I can close my eye and answer that
yes.
one. All right, so tell us answer to number seven. Let's see if you get it there.
What God did. What does God respond to when Hezekiah, he extended his life.
Okay.
Rudy Koto says he extended his life. Rudy
Koto
Philip.
Philip, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I'm lengthening his life, right?
Extended his life.
Right. Rondell is there. Rondell.
Alan Yes to his life. Extends his life. Extended his life.
Right, very
longer
nice, longer
right.
life. By 15 more
by
years.
By 15
right?
more years.
Yes.
Yeah.
Right, look, somebody's saying it.
For 15.
Yeah.
Very nice.
15 more years.
Kimberly
right, Kimberly.
Is
yes,
there.
Man.
Right on target.
That's
you know?
It, and on the ball again.
Very nice,
yeah.
Very nice. Next one. Who's turn?
Question number 8. What did the Lord do when Job prayed for his friends?
Mm-hmm.
What did the Lord do when Job prayed for his friends?
Right. I'll give them a clue one time, you know.
Okay, and the clue can be found in Job chapter 42 and verse 10.
All right, we give you everything.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
Full package.
Yes.
What did the Lord do when Job prayed for his friends? Mm-hmm. Let's hear. After this one, two more to come, and then we have a special item for you, man. Come, you got to stay with us tonight on Adventist Youth Live.
Right.
All right. I'm seeing some answers coming in there, but still, for the previous question, you have a new one there coming. What it says? Look at it.
His possession.
Rondell Wilson.
Mm-hmm.
Who is this person, boy? the person is on the ball. Double his
possessions.
Yes.
Ah, boy, double his possessions.
Oh, yeah.
Very nice. And double his possession. Karen Batiste is on.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Somebody saying, restore what he had lost.
Yes.
Chima, yeah, Chima is there, not quite, but Jason John says restored, you know, what he had lost,
yes.
Yeah,
yes.
Right, very nice, good attempt.
Nova and Randall had it, double his possession,
yes.
Right,
yeah.
Very nice,
double
his restored his fortunes,
yeah.
All right, good, so number nine,
yes.
My turn,
mm-hmm.
Right, number 10, Randall coming in there, Chomin Bihari says, yeah, very nice, number nine, who responded to Daniel's prayer of confession? Who responded to Daniel's prayer of confession? You can see, go to Daniel 9, verses 4, 5, 21. I give you everything there. Daniel chapter 9, 4, 5, and 29. Who responded to Daniel's prayer of confession? Who responded? Right? Daniel 9, 4, 5, and 21. You can go there and find it. Who responded to Daniel's prayer of confession? All right, that's the question. People are still answering the previous one. Very nice, very nice. The answers are coming in different forms, but you're all on target, yeah. Very nice, very nice. But who responded to Daniel's prayer of confession? If you go to Daniel 9, 4, 5, and 21, you should see the answer there.
Okay,
right.
Rondell.
Wow, Rondell Wilson is coming. He says what? The
angel
Gabriel. Savannah, is that correct?
Yes, that is correct.
All right, boy.
And Kimberly right. Phillips says, Gabriel.
Gabriel.
Eskeli on the ball.
Nova Noll says,
Gabriel.
Yeah. Jason John couldn't write Gabriel. He said,
God.
But that's all right. Glendon Lord. Hey, Glendon, you there, man. Glendon, like the page and share the page, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
He says, Jesus, but that's nice. Daniela Noel is just joined us. Kimo says, Gabriel. Right? Keisha says, God. And Gabriel, but
right,
it's the angel Gabriel, yeah?
Yes.
Right, right. Very right. Nice. Last one. Last question.
Number 10. Where was Jonah when he prayed to God?
Let me answer that one, please.
No. Easy question. You all don't have to get no clue for that one.
Really?
Where was Jonah when he prayed to God?
Yeah, where was Jonah when he prayed to God?
Yes.
But they wouldn't let me answer that one.
No, Pastor.
I tell you. Brace your seats. We have a new guest to introduce in a while, and we still have item of special music. Rondell Wilson is there. He's there. What is the answer? He says fish.
In the belly of the fish.
Angel Abraham says, in the belly of the fish.
Yes.
Wow.
Karen Batiste says, in the belly of the fish.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
That's
yes.
why I wanted
that
to answer that, you see.
Yes, fish.
Yeah.
In the belly of the fish. Fish.
Yeah. Very nice. Very
correct.
Nice.
That's
in the belly of the fish.
Yes,
Tony
yes.
and Noel hosting, right?
In the
hosting
big
Noel.
Fish.
Kimberly saying a big fish.
Yes.
In the big fish.
Yeah. Karina Philip is there. Well, if you like, everybody get a one right
yeah,
now.
Yeah, right. In the belly of the fish.
Sure.
In the fish. Fish.
Yeah. That one need to put my name there too.
Yeah.
Anyway.
Way
right
down
right.
in the depths of the sea.
Yeah.
The belly of the fish.
Come
way
on.
Down
let's
in the depths.
Let's give everybody a round of applause. Very nice. Well done. And as we can have fun studying and interacting with the Bible,
yeah.
There's so many things in the Bible. But folks, we're going to take a break now, yeah? We're going to take a break now. Thanks for, you know, engaging us and being with us. Stay tuned. We have something special for you. And then when we come back, we have another guest to introduce to you. And we're going to have a wonderful time. So let's take a break now as we entertain a special item of music. Enjoy.
John saw a city that could not be hid. John saw the city, oh yes he did. John caught a glimpse of the golden throne. Tell me all about it. Go right on around the throne. He saw the crystal sea. There's got to be more. What will it be? I want to go into the city he saw, New Jerusalem. Jerusalem, I want to walk your streets that are golden, and I want to run where the angels have trod. Of your river in the city of God. John saw the lion laid down by the lamb. I want to know everything about that land. John saw the day, but he did not see night. The Lamb of God, well, he must be the light. And he saw the saints worship the great I Am, crying, worthy, worthy is the Lamb. I want to go into the city he saw, New Jerusalem. Streets that are golden, and I want to run where the angels have trod. Jerusalem, I want to rest on the banks of your river, in that city, the city of God. Jerusalem. pearl strings that are golden. And I want to run where the angels have trod. Jerusalem, I want to rest on the banks of your river. In the city of God, city of God.
Item of special music there from Sister Ruan Lyons. Yeah, she's the wife of Pastor Bernard Lyons. Thank you very much, Jerusalem. That's a wonderful name.
Oh, yeah,
Jerusalem.
Mm-hmm.
I wanna, you know, next time. But wonderful, wonderful, wonderful. Well, we had a wonderful time thus far.
Of course.
We're gonna discuss. We're talking about Jesus on the main line. And I think somebody alluded to what we're really talking about. We are talking about prayer tonight. Yeah, Jesus on the main line. Tell him what you want. Mm-hmm. You know that little name?
Yes,
Jesus on the main line, tell him. And tonight, we've introduced a new guest. Let me introduce to you, Kishon Cornwall. Kishon, you're from Mount Rose, yes?
Yes,
In St. Patrick's.
Yes.
It's your first time on Adventist Youth Live?
Yes, first time.
First time. Well, yes. Relax, you know, don't worry. I'm right here. Don't watch live, but just watch, you know, and so on, by the grace of God. We're very happy that you can come. That's how we do it on Youth Live. We look for new people, and we expose them, you know. It's unplugged. So just be yourself, you know, by the grace of God, and He will give you the strength so that we can have a wonderful time tonight, yeah? So we thank you for coming, and we look forward to what you have to share with us tonight. All right, so folks, we tonight we're talking about Jesus on the main line, and from the quiz you would realize that we are talking about prayer tonight. About prayer. Pastor Lambert, you figured out that?
Yeah, definitely.
Because prayer is important, and in light of young people, we are beginning a special week from tomorrow, please God, of prayer emphasis. We should pray all the time, but that week is loaded and laced with prayer. Emphasis, encouraging our young people to pray more and to spend more time with God. You know, it's a powerful week, yeah? And so tonight we want to begin. We want to just prepare you and put you in the mood for what is to come by the grace of God, right?
Amen.
Natoya Hosten says, she says, the program tonight is about answered prayer. When we stay connected to God and trust in Him, wonderful healing miracles happen. This girl, she gone into
the program.
Yeah, but nice. We like your comment, or you just give a nice little summary there. So, right. So, folks, tell us. Let's talk a little bit, and we entertain your views. You know, what is prayer? What is prayer? I have something here. You might have something. What is prayer? You know, what is prayer? Kishon, you look like you want to start, you know.
Basically, I view prayer as communication with God.
Ah.
Talking to God, opening your heart to God.
Very nice, That's how you view it, Right, very, very good, very good. Yeah, that's a good way of looking at it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Ludin, what is prayer?
Well, to me, I believe that prayer is a solemn request.
Oh, solemn request.
Yes, a solemn request for help or for giving thanks, an expression of thanks, and it's directly addressed to God,
an
object of worship. So it can be, as I said, a request, or an expression for help, and an object of worship.
Right.
I wrote it out because I didn't want to forget, and I'm still fumbling. So let me just read it.
No, that's
it's,
okay.
All right, a solemn request for help or an expression of thanks addressed to God or an object of worship.
Right. And folks, let me just say something tonight. Two of our special guests on this panel tonight, you're gonna hear from them. The testimonies of what prayer has done. And Lunin is one of those persons, right? So I want you to bear with her. She's still recovering from a major accident, well, that she had that had interfered with her, right? So I want to say that on your behalf to protect and shield you. So sometimes the trend of thought, but we thought it best because she has a powerful testimony that she's going to share with us a little later, and so do Keisha, so does Keisha rather, and they're going to share with us. Prayer, like what is prayer, you know?
Prayer is when you and God have a sweet relationship and you could tell him anything, anytime,
mm-hmm.
and just be open with him.
A sweet relationship.
Yeah, straight up.
Right.
Yes. You don't try to sugarcoat anything to tell him because you have something good with him.
Yeah.
So you don't try to tell him the good things and hold back. Just tell him.
Right.
Yeah. They say Jesus on the main line, and when you're on the main line, just tell him.
Yeah.
Yes. Right? So you don't have to look for no special place.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you have special place and time,
mm-hmm.
but generally you should be able to speak to him anytime, anywhere, at any circumstance.
Right. So I wanna throw that at you.
Mm-hmm.
In the book Steps to Christ, Ellen G. White, I found this very, very powerful.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
Ellen G. White says, it is the breath of the soul.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And that's what I said. Anytime, anywhere.
The key in the hand of faith to unlock heaven's doors.
Yes.
She also says, Kishan, she also says, it is the opening of the heart to God,
mm-hmm.
as to a friend.
Yeah.
Yes.
Eh? You're like that.
Mm-hmm. Tell him as it is.
Yeah. Tell him as it is.
Don't hide nothing. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Right?
He's on the main line. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And that's very important.
Yeah. Right.
Mm-hmm. And the breath of the soul, that's why I said, anytime, anyway.
Yeah.
Because you can't say, okay, well, I will breathe right here, and when I go home, I'll stop breathing. No,
yeah.
You have to breathe all the time.
All the time.
Yes. The time you stop breathing, you die.
Right.
So that's how you should be praying all the time, about open communication,
right,
with God.
Right. I want to show that question to you guys just now, but hear what Ruth Dikoto is saying something. Ludin, could you read that for us? Ruth Dikoto Phillips, she says what?
Talking to God
as to a friend.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. She said that even before I read the quote.
Yeah.
So that was,
yeah,
she was,
mm-hmm.
right on target.
Mm-hmm.
Dwight McLeish says expression of thanks addressed to God.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Addressed to God. What June Thomas says.
Good night sayings of God.
Very nice. Very nice. And Hostin says amen. Right?
Mm-hmm.
Very nice. Keep your comments coming.
Yes.
Your comments, your own thoughts about prayer and so on. But
I also see prayer as a privilege. Because, you know, like when you have to meet like a prime minister or the governor or somebody, you have to make an appointment.
Yeah.
To make, and sometimes you make the appointment and you don't even get through. But a privilege, we have the privilege to talk to the ruler of the universe anytime, any way we want. We have that constant communication with him.
Yeah.
I see it as a privilege.
Right?
Yes.
That PowerPoint, you know.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
That PowerPoint. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Very nice, very nice. The creator of the universe.
Yes,
nice.
We have that privilege.
But let me ask you guys this question. There are young people who say, and I hear it even not too long ago, that, hey, well, let me tell you, Pastor, God knows what I want. God knows everything. So why have to pray? Why have to pray?
Well, for me,
mm-hmm.
prayer is not only about what you're asking God for.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Prayer is about relationship.
Right. Mm-hmm.
So
yes.
If you have a friend, you don't only talk to your friend when you want something from your friend.
Mm-hmm.
No.
Mm-hmm.
You talk to your, because even though your friend come in on vacation, if they're not in the country, they will bring something for you as your friend.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Right?
Yeah.
But when you talk to them, how you doing? How is the family? How is work today? How is life? General talk, and that's what God wants. God wants a relationship.
Yes.
He don't just want to. I give you this, and you ask for this. I give you this, and you ask. No.
Right.
He doesn't want that.
Hold on a while, because I want to. Our comments are coming. Go back. Let me see. Rhonda says there is. Yeah, come down. She says right. Julissa Boyce. I hope I have it right. She says Ellen G. White also says it brings us up to God, referring to prayer. So
mm-hmm.
prayer brings us up to God. Isn't that wonderful?
Mm-hmm.
I love how you put that there, God, how you summarize that statement from Ellen G. White. Rhonda Cornwall says, there is no time or place in which it is inappropriate to offer up a petition to God.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah? Very nice, very nice. All right? And then we have Olga Lindsay just says, happy Sabbath. Saints, yeah. Jane Ragbasin says, good night and happy Sabbath. Very nice. These are new. We welcome you. Remember to like the page and share the page, yeah? Wamak is also there. He says, prayer is the ability to be able to talk to the Most High in good times and in bad times.
Yes, man.
I love that. Isn't that wonderful?
Yes.
Right. Mm. So keep the comments coming as we interrupt. So Lambert, I interrupted you, but I know you want to continue, yeah?
Yeah, so I was saying you don't only communicate when you want something,
mm-hmm.
but you communicate to maintain a relationship.
Yeah.
right? And the important thing about our relationship with God mm-hmm. is that the sweeter and the closer the relationship gets,
yeah.
is more we become like Him. So the relationship is not worthless, but the relationship has profit. Mm-hmm. And just as in physical, if we are aligned to the wrong type of relationship, it can affect us negatively.
Right.
So once we are aligned to God, which is the best friend to have, we will become more like Him, and our character will develop and shape into becoming better individuals.
Right. Mm-hmm. Very nice, very nice, very nice.
And
yes.
God also wants us to pray for Him to get the glory. Mm-hmm. Even when Jesus was down here, He prayed to God. And when God answered His spirit, all the glory went up to God.
Mm-hmm.
So like, if we get something, we mightn't see that as that important, but when we pray for it, when we go down on our knees and we beg God for it, and then we receive it, mm-hmm. then we give God all the glory and all the praise. It's all about God getting the glory. It's all about putting God in the spotlight.
Mm-hmm.
When we receive certain things that we pray for,
mm-hmm.
it's all about putting God in the spotlight. So God knows that we want the need, mm-hmm. but He wants the glory.
Right.
So He wants us to ask Him for it,
mm-hmm.
and then He gives it to us.
Right, very nice. I see you wearing a ring on your finger. You're married?
Yes, I'm married,
okay.
Pastor.
I'm just minding your business.
Yes. I'm recently married.
Okay, right.
I'm recently married.
Find it, a wife, find it a good deal.
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
Jesus' name.
Oh, yeah.
But he got, I like to tease my friend, but of course he has something to tell us about that, young people. And you got to stay tuned. You got to, this part, you got to like it. You got to share the page. You got to call all your friends and tell them, this guy has something special to talk about. So I'm just putting you on a lot that he's talking about something just now. Don't tell them yet. I will tell you when to tell them. Right? Dennis John says, and she says what? She says
God's
Dennis
phone
John,
number is never busy.
Whoa. Boy, this online viewers tonight, they're shooting, boy. Big PowerPoint, yeah? He's never busy. Yeah, you're the phone, sometimes the network breakdown.
Yeah,
Jesus on the main line, man. You can call Him up anytime. You don't need no password. You don't need no top up. You don't need no credit. Come on, young people out there. In Jesus' name. Hear what Ronald Phillips says, my good friend from Maribor. Yeah, what he says there?
He said, praise God's loving way. praise God's loving way of connecting with man.
Ah, beautiful, beautiful. Ludi, you want to read what John Max also says?
Yes, he said, prayer is talking and believing what you are saying and getting.
Mm-hmm.
Prayer also helps you understand things which are not seen.
Oh, beautiful, beautiful, yeah? Mm-hmm. Beautiful, very nice, very nice.
Mm-hmm.
So let's move on. Right, I'm coming to the part now. We want to talk a little bit. Folks, we want to talk a little bit. You have some testimonies, you know, of how God has answered your prayer and God has answered your prayer. You may not be able to talk about everything, right? But I know Keyshawn, you have a very special one, you know.
Yes.
So we manage the time. Give us, you know, you can tell us everything. It will take us, I guess, a long time. But
mm-hmm.
you know, Ludi, I know you have something special to share with us tonight, and of course I know Lambert, he has a whole book library of prayers of his own experience, yeah, of his own experience, you know. So I want to start with Lulin. I want to start with you tonight.
Okay.
I want to start with you tonight.
Okay.
Share in a nutshell with us tonight, yeah.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Well, for those of you who do not know, I met in an accident on the 3rd of December 2016.
Ah.
And it was really, really bad.
Yeah.
It left me broken mentally, physically, spiritually.
Wow.
And for a while, I was really, really angry.
Yeah.
Wow.
I was angry at God. I was angry at the guy who you know, bumped me.
You say you were angry at God?
I was angry at God, Pastor.
Okay.
I was angry at God. I was angry at the guy who, you know, bumped me from behind.
Wow.
I was angry at the conference. I was angry at my husband. I was just angry. I had this anger.
You're angry at Andy too?
Everybody, Pastor.
Okay.
Because I thought...
Me too?
I thought if the conference didn't have that activity, then I would be at my home, not going to something.
It was you were going to a conference activity.
Yes.
All right.
And then, you know, Andy...
What was that activity, by the way?
I think it was something for couples.
Oh,
and
for
I
couples,
told, yeah.
Couple enrichment seminar.
Right.
Very nice.
And but I was on my way to pick up Andy to get there, so I was mad that he wasn't home to drive us there.
Oh.
I was mad at the guy because I thought he could have, you know, probably drive with a little bit more due care and attention.
Mm-hmm.
I was angry at God because I couldn't understand why he allowed this to happen to me.
Yeah.
And for a while, I was just, you know, mad at everything and everybody.
Mm-hmm.
Until, you know, pastors came to visit me at the hospital and they would pray to me. And yes, I would listen and, you know, I would have this attitude, yeah, you could pray, you could say whatever you want.
Uh-huh.
But, you know,
uh-huh.
And then there was this young lady from St. David's Church,
mm-hmm.
Sister Diana.
Yeah.
I can't remember what her last name is. She used to be Maureen before.
Maureen, okay.
And she came and she, you know, she prayed with me, she cried with me, she shared some of her testimonies of, you know, battles that she has fought, she and God,
mm-hmm.
and how they were able to get through it together.
Mm-hmm.
And that kind of touched a spot. And then I remember you were one of the first persons who came to visit me at home,
yeah,
to pastor.
Yeah, yeah.
And you said, you know, weeping may endure for a night, but joy would come in the morning. And there were certain
mm-hmm.
things that you said to me
mm-hmm.
that kind of got me thinking.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And then I started to pray. A little by little, I started to pray with my family and those who would come around.
Yeah.
And then I started to see things happening.
Right.
So then we would go to doctors and they would say, you know what? This is not going to happen. You need to do this or you need to do that. And I you know, it kind of broke my spirit a little bit. But then I started saying, I said, God, you hear that?
Mm-hmm.
It's me and you in this thing together here.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I say, you brought me here.
Mm.
You need to get me out of here.
Amen.
And little by little, they told me that, you know, my back was damaged, my neck, I couldn't move well. When you came, you saw.
Yeah.
I couldn't move my neck, I couldn't get up, I had to lie for quite a while. And, you know, I was just mad. And then I said, God, no, I
Hold
don't
on,
understand.
I just want to paint the picture. When not only that, back and neck, but her memory was also affected. Ludin couldn't remember what she was asking Andy, always have to ask Andy, who's Pastor Andy, I kept Pastor Ile, you know?
Mm-hmm.
She was that bad, you know? Mm-hmm. That's why we you know, she has a testimony. Continue, Ludin.
Yes, so you know, we would go to the doctors, I would
mm-hmm.
say, and they would tell me, you know, this is not gonna happen and I need to do this and I need to do that and it's gonna be a slow process and all of that. And as I said, it got me really, really discouraged.
Mm-hmm.
And then as I started to pray and I said, God, you brought me here. You
yeah.
need to get me out.
Mm-hmm.
I said, it's you and me in this thing together.
Mm.
And then things started happening. When I go and they tell me you couldn't do this, I came back and I prayed and I said, God, let's show them.
Amen.
And eventually we just started to move. And, you know, Alina and a few of them in my church, they used to call me slow march or slow walk.
Mm-hmm.
Because I couldn't walk.
Yes,
I couldn't run.
Mm-hmm.
And gradually everything they told me that I couldn't do, I came home and I prayed and I proved, and we proved them wrong.
Praise God.
So I'm just grateful today for Jesus and anybody
yes.
that thinks that Jesus isn't alive.
Huh.
Oh my God, Jesus is such a powerful, such a powerful being.
Mm-hmm.
You just have to
yes.
pray and continue to have faith and trust that
yeah.
if you pray, God is going to answer. And one thing that I said, God, sometimes when you're going through stuff, you believe that God isn't there.
Mm-hmm.
And I said, God, reveal yourself to me.
Yeah.
Let me know that you are there.
Yes.
So as I prayed, he started showing up himself, letting me know that he's there because things started happening
mm-hmm.
for me.
Mm-hmm.
And I was just really grateful that I'm not there anymore. And I mean, I still have challenges.
Yes,
I still
yes.
go through different things on a daily basis. But
yeah.
I can see God working through me and, you know, with
mm-hmm.
me, and I'm just grateful.
Amen.
Amen.
Come on, man.
Amen.
Big
Amen.
Up at Jesus now, man.
Amen.
Big up at Jesus now,
man.
Yeah, man. Come. Let's see how the I guess the online viewers are reacting there. You know.
And Pastor, I must say there was one time well, I couldn't really run because normally when I walk too fast or I run,
yeah.
I would feel this sharp
pain.
In my back.
Wow.
So I would just have to stop and, you know,
mm-hmm.
cry out.
Mm-hmm.
But there was this one time I went to Grenville
mm-hmm.
and rain started to pour, Pastor.
Mm-hmm.
And everybody was running and I know I couldn't. And I said, God, I can't be soaked because I have to go get the bus
yeah.
to get home. And it's like somebody just tapped my leg and I started to run
uh-huh.
and then I went inside of Andal and I just shout out hallelujah.
Amen.
And everybody looked at me like I was getting crazy, but I knew what God did.
Yes.
You know, and from then it became, you know, a gradual process, but you know, God has taken me from there to here, and I just want to give him
amen.
Thanks. And
would you just say amen?
Amen. Amen.
I
mean, amen.
You, but I feel the thing, boy. You know, with Jesus on the main line, tell you what you want, tell you what you want. All you don't know that thing. But let's go. Maxine, no, hey, Maxine is there. Hello, Maxine. How you doing, man? Maxine Noel, boy. That name, yes. Come, tell us what Maxine saying here tonight. Tell us what Maxine saying.
He said, happy Sabbath to my wonderful family. I'm truly blessed with this evening's program thus far.
Praise God.
Sister Bess, without a test, there cannot be a testimony.
Yeah.
I'm so happy to see that you are back on your feet giving praise to God.
Amen. 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 Praise God. Aldridge Womack?
Womack.
Aldridge, he's saying.
Prayer, Sister Bess. God's arm is always open, waiting for us to come in.
Amen.
Give God the prayer, the praise.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yes.
Oh, praise God. Praise God. And
to God.
I know, Ludin, that, you know, you had a real challenge. And let me tell you something about her. Of course, the memory was almost gone, I could tell you, because I interacted with her, visited her, and so on. When I saw she moved very slow, and then I understand she was taking some classes. I say, well, how she's taking classes with that kind of state? But she was determined and she was praying, you know. God was answering. Then we had the training for master guides and so on, and the all the dates and church history and all them kind of thing. Ludin was at the training and doing well and interacting, and I saw the progress, and you know, and you know, you've come a long way to God in glory, would somebody
amen.
Say
amen. 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 Amen.
Wonderful. Rhonda Cornwall says amen, hallelujah, praise. Amazing, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Yeah.
Thank you for all the hallelujah.
Amen.
Yeah, praise God. And all your fans, look, people are saying, you know, Christy Roberts says, praise God has a plan for my dear. And even as you listen to this testimony, young people, I want to pause and challenge you tonight. Yeah? Whatever the situation you are in, whatever the situation you are in, and it is true that our young people are going through challenges, and parents and viewers alike, you are going through challenges. But God is still a prayer answering God.
Amen.
He's
amen.
Still in the miracle working business. And it doesn't happen in some cases where people have to throw you down and do all kind of things. You just have to go to him in prayer and talk to him. Would you say amen?
Amen.
Yeah?
Amen, amen.
All right. Chanel London Taylor, Brooklyn, New York, in the house, neighbors. That's my
yeah.
my neighbor, Mr. London's daughter. You know, how are you doing? All right, be encouraged, sister. God is not a man that he should lie. He is your healer, and God doesn't do partial healing. He is a God of completion.
Amen.
And yes, thank you very much, and God bless you. Thanks for this comment. We wanted to address something before. The Hines family who was watching.
Oh, yeah,
there was
yeah,
another
yeah.
family. Come on, help me.
Yeah,
with
well,
this
the, we just want to say good night and happy Sabbath to the Hines family,
yeah.
who is accompanying the Felix family, who is looking from Ontario, Canada.
Mm-hmm.
God bless you, and we are happy that you are with us tonight.
Yes.
All right. So continue right. viewing and share the page with your friends and family, so they can gain in the blessing what is happening here tonight.
Yes. Yeah. Very nice. Very nice. All right, so that was one on healing and so on. We want to move to another one. We want to move to another testimony. Kishan,
yes.
welcome, you know, welcome, welcome.
Yes.
And I was telling them a while ago, watching your finger, you married, and there's a ring on your finger, you know, and that kind of thing. Young man, you know, young man
yes.
and so on. And you work in the family business, you know,
yes.
family has a little business and you work there and so on, you know. I know your testimony, it would take us a long time, but summarize it
yes.
for us as Linda, and
okay.
tell us the gist
okay.
of
yes.
your testimony
yes.
tonight. Yeah,
okay.
Let's hear another perspective
okay.
as you listen.
Yeah. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Well, my testimony
mm-hmm.
is, well, as Pastor says, a big testimony, but I'll try to see how I could slim it down once.
Slim it down, right?
Yes.
Very nice, man.
Yes.
Yeah.
You see, most of the youths, we believe in prayer.
Yeah.
And we pray for things like healing.
Mm-hmm.
We pray for things like protection,
mm-hmm.
for provision. We pray for things like that.
Mm-hmm.
But when it comes to relationship, we tend to leave God out of it.
Relationship?
I don't know why. We tend to leave God out of it.
All right. When you say but relationship with
when it comes to
parents and so on and that kind of thing, with your parents, with your friends. So.
No, when it comes to dating and courtship,
we tend to
leave God out of it. I don't know why.
Mm-hmm.
But well, I kinda am guilty of that.
Mm-hmm.
I went into a relationship and well, I didn't pray for God to show me. I see the person and physical attraction.
Mm-hmm.
So I went into the relationship and I spent 3 years into the relationship and then the relationship ended.
Hmm.
And I was thinking, wow, I spent a whole 3 years and then it just come to an end.
Hmm.
What if I spend a whole 3 years again in the next relationship and it comes to an end and then the same thing again, then all my youth will be done. So I start thinking, well, what to do?
All my
and
youth.
There, there's, yeah. All my youth.
Hold on, man. Hold
all
on.
My youth life.
Yeah.
Will be gone.
Yeah. Yes. I like how you put it.
Yes.
Yeah. Continue.
So I start thinking, what to do? There are so much of pretenders out there.
Mm-hmm.
What to do?
Mm.
And then I decide, once God choose somebody for you, then you cannot go wrong.
Okay, okay.
You cannot go wrong.
And tell them that.
Yes.
Say that.
Yeah. Everyone, once God choose someone for you, you cannot go wrong.
Amen.
Cannot go wrong.
Yeah.
God doesn't make no mistake.
True, true.
If it's one thing I know, my God doesn't make no mistake.
Amen. So what did you do?
I started praying for God to show me who my wife is.
Mm-hmm.
So I did a 4-day prayer and fast. I did a 5-day prayer and fast.
Amen.
And then I did a 10-day prayer and fast.
Amen.
You prayed and fasted?
Yes.
Amen.
For God to show me who my wife will be.
Amen.
That's how bad I wanted it.
Oh, right.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
And I got a dream. I dreamed that I proposed to this young lady. She was my best friend at the time.
Mm-hmm.
So I dreamed that I proposed to her.
Mm-hmm.
The morning when I wake up, I call her, but I didn't tell her I dream I proposed to her.
Okay.
I told her I dream I proposed last night, but I didn't tell her was her.
Step by step.
Yeah, I didn't tell her was her.
Come on.
Come on.
She was also praying for God to show her who her husband shall be, and she dreamed that she saw me in the dream.
Alright.
So she told you that?
Well, she didn't tell me yet.
Oh, she didn't tell you yet.
She saw me in the dream.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
And she was saying, she had a little doubt. She had a little doubt.
Mm-hmm.
So she prayed again.
Mm-hmm.
And she got the same dream.
Mm-hmm.
And she saw me again in the same dream.
Wow.
And she was like, that had to be my husband.
Mm-hmm.
So she was praying to God now. That God not only show her, but show me too.
Oh.
But not knowing, God already showed me, but I didn't tell her.
Mm-hmm.
So we was best friends at the time.
Mm-hmm.
And then she was praying, and then she decided to pray for God to show her brother in the church. I am really a husband, for God to show her brother in the church.
Mm-hmm.
And just so the brother in the church come and tell her how I'm a husband. And when she come to me with the news, I was like, well, why didn't tell me? Look, I got the dream.
Mm-hmm.
I told you I got the dream. I proposed. You didn't ask me who who I proposed to. And she was like, why I didn't tell her? And we was like back and forth.
Mm-hmm.
And then we was like, what shall we do? Shall we be best friends still? Shall we get into a relationship?
Mm-hmm.
What shall we do?
Mm-hmm.
And then we went to God again and prayed.
Plenty prayer, man. Amen.
Mm-hmm. Yes. And God set up everything for us.
Mm-hmm.
He give us directions.
Mm-hmm.
He give us the date of the wedding.
Mm-hmm.
There's something special about that date, eh?
That's special about that date.
He give us the date of the wedding. He give us the color of the wedding.
Mm-hmm.
And everything he give us in terms of planning for the wedding.
Mm. Come, let's see what hold on. I wonder. Let's see our online viewers. You know, yeah. Let's see somebody comments. Now they're there and they're listening intently. Mm-hmm. Chome Mitchell says, "To God be the glory. Great things He has done."
Yeah.
And this one, with the previous one was with Ludin, was about healing and restoration, that kind of thing. Now we're talking about relationship, because sometimes we think a relationship, God, it doesn't matter, yeah?
Yeah.
But it's very important. God is also interested in young people in your relationship.
Yes,
especially
that's
true. Your lifetime partner, the person you're going to spend your life with for the rest of your life, is interested in that. So there is no need to rush or take it outside. But here we have a testimony, a powerful testimony about how this young man, Keyshawn, has prayed and fasted and God answered, you know. Abigail James Williams is saying, good night to all, Pastor Lambert and Pastor Hile. Special good night to you. Thank you very much. Good night to you also. Right? Chima Hamlet says, no better matchmaker than God.
Amen.
Yes.
Amen.
Is there a song, something like that? Matchmaker, you know, but yeah. And then Ronald Wilson said, that experience needs to be put into a book.
Oh, yes.
Put into a book. Right? Woman says, interesting love story, brother.
Mm-hmm.
You know? All I was thinking a while ago, you have any more cake from the wedding? Right? But that's good. You know, yes. Tell us, Cassandra Strong says, putting God in the midst of everything is the best thing to do. Too often we leave God out and then want Him to fix the problems.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah? Very nice. So just sum up in a few seconds that aspect of the testimony, and then we're going to take a break and come back with another aspect of testimony. So just sum up, you know.
So He give us the date of the wedding,
mm-hmm.
and we plan for the date of the wedding. We plan for the date, but we didn't know where the stuff are going to come from to do the wedding.
Mm-hmm.
But yet still, we follow God.
Yeah.
God tell us not to worry.
Yeah.
He will take care of everything.
Mm-hmm.
And just so we trust in God.
Mm-hmm.
When I tell my auntie about the wedding, she was so shocked. She got goosebumps.
Mm-hmm.
She was like, I was praying for one of my sons to get married on my birthday, and the wedding is falling directly on her birthday.
Mm-hmm.
And I wasn't knowing, not knowing to me, that her sisters in Canada was also planning to come down and do something for her birthday.
Mm-hmm. Come on now.
She said, is a wedding she planning, is a wedding she prayed for, and is a wedding she's getting. So just so, my aunties in Canada came down, and just so they turned the birthday party that they was planning, they turned it into the wedding.
Wow.
Isn't God is so great. God is so awesome.
Praise God.
Even when we could not see, we trusted Him, and we planned for that date. Other people look to tell us different.
Mm-hmm.
Tell us, well, look, we didn't see that. But we say, God give us that date,
amen.
And we are going with this date.
Amen.
Yes,
God.
And the wedding was a success.
Praise
Everything God. Runs smoothly. Even the week before the wedding, I went on a fast, and I was fasting and praying for smooth running of the wedding and everything.
Yeah.
And God said, not to worry, I will handle everything.
Amen.
And just so the wedding was smooth, it was a success. And everything just worked out smoothly and in order.
Right.
Yes. God is so awesome.
Come on, man. Somebody give God praise.
Amen.
There,
God
man.
Is so great. God
glory.
Is so great.
Praise God. Praise
God wants to be in everything.
Yes.
And He wants us to follow Him. Just trust in Him and follow Him.
Right. Very nice. Keyshawn boy, I tell you, we could go on and on. And I know you have a lot of stories, yeah? Aisha just joined. Ruth Dakota says, heavy stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Need to document. You hear?
Yes.
That's not the right, man. Kibo says, this is so amazing. It shows that God is concerned about every aspect of our lives, and He will always direct us when we honestly seek His direction.
Yes.
And so this youth week of prayer that is coming up, beginning, well, tomorrow on the brighter side, on the Sabbath, on the brighter side, is also to get you in tune with God, yeah? And I'm guarantee you, as you place yourself in the presence and at the disposal of God, as you pray, young people, come out and petition, whatever the challenge is, whatever your request, let it be known to God, and He will answer you. Let's
Amen.
Take a break for at this moment as we take an item of special music, and we'll be back with more testimonies as we talk about Jesus on the main line.
Amen.
There's no place to go, you think no one knows. knows what you're going through. When you've done all you can, you're exhausted, my friend, and there's nothing else you can do. When life overpowers you, or someone betrays you, you feel like nobody cares. There's still one place I know, when there's no place to go, I can go to the Master in prayer. I can go to the Master, he always listens. He welcomes my pleas because he cares about me. He won't overlook my petition. He's standing above and he's watching in love. He's waiting my burdens to bear. He's got time for you and a place for me too. I can go to the Master in prayer.
When the world turns on me, I'm so blind I can't see. Doubts are everywhere. When friends turn me down and my spirit is bound, I can't rise above all my fears. When pain won't release me, there's no peace within me. I'm feeling like life isn't fair. When my night's sleep is lost and I've turned and I've tossed, I can go to the Master in prayer.
I can go to the Master, he always listens. He welcomes my pleas because he cares about me. He won't overlook my petitions. He's standing above and he's watching in love. He's waiting my burdens to bear. He's standing above and he's watching in love. He's waiting your burdens to bear. He's got time for you and a place for me too. You can go to the Master in prayer.
If life's a dead end, I can still recommend
you can go to the Master in prayer.
Thank you very, very much. That was a wonderful special music. Yeah? Yeah, isn't that? It's R&B Outreach Ministries, right? I can go to the Master. They're coming out of Guav. Yeah, a group of young people using their talents to praise and glorify God. Yeah? We had two powerful testimonies on this program tonight as we talk about prayer, and the topic is Jesus on the Main Line. Yeah. Very, very wonderful from Sister Ludin Bess and Kishan Cornwall. Lambert, you're not left out, you know. You'd want to share something with us of one of your experiences, you know, in a nice nutshell kind of form, you know. And so, and tell us, Lambert, give us. You have a lot of testimonies, I know. All right.
Mm-hmm. All right. There are many, but I just speak about the one when I was going to study.
Yeah.
When I was planning to go to study, the first time I came to the conference here, I remember I came and I spoke to the president and I told him that I have a desire to go and study to become a pastor.
Mm-hmm.
What are the requirements? And he said you need five subjects including maths and English.
Mm-hmm.
But I didn't have English, so I had to go and do English. I had a five, I did it personally, I got a four.
Mm-hmm.
Then I took some classes and I got a three.
Mm-hmm.
And after that I went to college here, T.M. Marisha Community College. When I finished, I decided I don't want to study no pastor again.
Mm-hmm.
I want to go and be an engineer, civil engineer. And when I was in the process of doing that, I got accepted for a job at Mount Joseph, just putting it in a nutshell.
Mm-hmm.
And then my mom and I, we decided, okay, we'll do something together, buy a vehicle, she maintain it, and I put the gas and so on and so forth.
Mm-hmm.
Anyway, in the process of that, when I graduated in July of 2010, she died August.
Oh,
right?
Sorry.
She was sick Friday, died Sunday, 48 years.
Wow.
And then after I took care of her in terms of a burial arrangement and so on, funeral arrangement, the money that she left was only for one semester.
Hmm.
And then I decided, God brought it back to my attention. Hey, remember when you went to do English, was to go to study in the ministry.
Ah.
And then I decided, well, I'm going. It was 14,600 EC that was remaining.
Hmm.
And I said, God, I'm going to study, but here my arrangement with you. When I go, when I come back, I want to be able to tell people what you have done for me.
Mm-hmm.
Plenty of people can read the Bible and they know what you do for Moses and Elijah and the children of Israel, but I want to see what you have done for me.
Yeah.
The first thing when I arrived to Trinidad, well, you know, I had a little credit card, debit card from your mother money. So I paid USC one time, mm-hmm. pay cash, everything. But where I was living, the only thing that I had to pay was respect.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Mm-hmm. So the only thing I had to pay there was respect.
Amen.
And I paid respect for a while and then I moved to another house.
Yeah.
And the places where I was living, the people never knew me from before. Never.
Right.
Right? So when I was staying there, they just have to trust me based on who I am, mm-hmm. and based on how God has inspired them.
Yes.
I'm just jumping ahead, coming to the end of my school year when I was about to graduate. I owed the school $19,000.
Hmm.
And other than that, God has been coming through for me.
Yeah.
I don't have time to go through all that.
Ask Pastor Jimmy God, you want to see him.
So when I was coming to the end there, there was a lady, she's from Colombia.
Mm-hmm.
Previously at the time we were just talking about faith and she said she had to increase her spiritual life and she said, well, I said, I have to do the same because, you know, I'm going to school. I need finance. She said, how much you need? I said, I need about 6,000. She said, okay, well, tomorrow, call me. She said, no, you give me a number. I will call you. And she sent 3,000 for me. That is Sunday morning.
Ah,
right?
Oh,
so that same lady, you know, I contacted that lady. And when I contacted her, she said, you know, God already told me to pay your entire tuition.
Mm.
Wow.
$19,000.
Mm-hmm.
TT. And I got some other help already. And by that time, I think I was owing about 10,000 something.
Mm-hmm.
She said, just meet one of my workers in Grenville, in Port of Spain, sorry.
Mm-hmm.
That Friday, meet one of my workers in Port of Spain Friday. And I met the guy there. We went up in school. And he paid with the credit card $10,100.
Mm-hmm.
Dollars. And God just took care of everything.
Amen. Wow.
Amen.
Right?
Wow.
So there are many, to lead up to that, many times God came awesome. Through for me.
Yeah.
But what I want to say to young people, this testimony is not just to speak about myself.
Yeah.
But when God has a calling on your life,
amen.
Whether it is pastoral, or whether it is to be a doctor, to, you know, you just want to further your study.
Mm-hmm.
You have to be able to trust in God.
Amen.
Yeah.
You wouldn't be smooth all the time. But I learned an old proverbs that says, rough seas make good sailors.
Mm-hmm.
So if you want to be able to be a good sailor, you want to be able to be a strong Christian, God have to put you through tests.
Mm-hmm.
And we have to learn to trust in Him, learn to pray. And once we pray, God answer our prayer, and this will help our Christian life to develop. Because many times we just want everything to go smooth.
Mm-hmm.
If everything goes smooth, you wouldn't be a strong Christian.
Sure.
But when you go difficult times, when you come through that difficult time, mm-hmm. you will be shining like a diamond for Jesus.
I'm telling you, boy, our online viewers, we even have time to interact with them as we should on this thing, because mm-hmm. somebody is saying here, this program needs to be repeated.
Mm-hmm.
And not only repeated, but extended maybe, because you have... I mean, and Lambert, I know you have a book, Ludin, you just scratch the surface, Keisha, you just, because I restricted you because we have a time constraint, you know,
mm-hmm.
but powerful testimonies to the honor and glory of God. Now, we talk about prayer, we want to spend some time praying tonight as we come, as we get ready to wrap up. The producers are listening, they saw your comments. They're going to think about whether part one, part two, or whatever part, you know. But we trust that tonight you have been stimulated, you have been challenged to have an active prayer life, yeah? And to trust God. Young people, adults alike, parents viewing this program, families are viewing this program, wherever you are, whatever the challenge, don't lose hope. Don't give up on God. We believe, we do not believe in magic and obia. And when I mean believe, there is bad, but we don't big up those things, man. We big up and we host
Jesus,
the power
Hallelujah.
Of God.
Amen,
and he's not only interested in the big things of your life, but he's also, as you heard from these persons here tonight, and many of you can testify also, he's interested in even the little things, the small things, you know. So tonight we wanna pray. So you may send a few requests tonight. Send a few requests to us tonight, and we can pray on them while I give the panelists, you know, just maybe a few seconds to, you know, just wrap up and say a few thoughts or something. Ludin, I want to start with you as I started. We're very happy that you could have been with us tonight, but you know, your final few little comments, you know.
Pastor, one thing I must say is that sometimes, you know, you might be like, while I was going through my rough period, there are times when I wanted to talk to somebody and it was like 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock in the night, and you know, sometimes Andy would be up hustling, bustling because I couldn't really do anything. So he got his little sleep and I didn't want to wake him to talk.
Yeah.
You know, you had a friend, your best friend, you can't call that friend because it's 1, 2 in the morning.
In the morning, yeah.
And so on. And you know, one thing that came to mind is that God never gets weary.
Amen.
Right?
Amen.
He's always there. It doesn't matter if you're up 2 or 3 in the morning time, he's always
there. He's on the main line.
Ready. Yes. Always on the main line. Yeah. Ready and waiting to hear what you have to say and to assist in any way.
Very nice. Very nice. Ludin, thanks, man. We're very, really happy that you can come tonight and what God has really done for you, you know? Right? Kishon? Always leave Lambert in the last in the middle there, you know? Yeah.
Well, I would just like to encourage people to involve God in every aspect of your life.
Mm-hmm.
Every aspect, like you want a new car, ask God for it.
Mm-hmm.
You want to change your job,
mm-hmm.
ask God if it's okay.
Mm-hmm.
Involve God. Sometimes we tend to leave out God in certain aspects and then go to God for certain things. But God wants to be a part of every aspect of your life.
Yeah.
He wants to mold you and make you into who he wants you to be. So we should trust him and put all our trust in him and depend on him for everything. Just involve him in everything.
Right.
Let him know you're feeling down. Let him know you're feeling happy. Give him the praise. Everything. Everything.
Very nice, very nice. Yeah, thank you very much. Lambert.
All right, just want to encourage you to have that close relationship with Jesus. So you'll not only go to him in state of emergency, but you'll go to him every day, every moment of the day.
Mm-hmm.
So when you call upon him, he wouldn't be a stranger, or your voice wouldn't be strange to his ears, but it would be a voice that he is accustomed to, because you all have a good relationship. So take that very seriously. Because in order to be a Christian and to be a successful Christian, to be triumphant, and to be an overcomer, you must be a praying Christian. God bless you.
Very nice, very nice. Tonight we want to pray. Guys, thank you very much for your testimonies. Our online viewers really did enjoy. You can see the comments. We don't have time to read all. I myself have been blessed and inspired by your testimonies. And we give God the praise, yeah? And the glory, and we say that God is still answering prayer. Let me share a few things. Prayer for all of us. Prayer is both a spiritual necessity and a privilege. I think you made that point. Our prayers are never burdens or wearies God. Yeah, never too heavy or weary, or he's annoyed with us, you know. We must pray to him. Prayer brings freshness to our spiritual life.
Amen.
Yes,
man.
Prayer freshness. Every sincere prayer is heard. Spiritual advance depends on prayer. If you want to move on spiritually and so on, it depends on prayer. And prayer is to be the first activity of the day. And may I say the first and the last activity? Prayer should be a lifestyle, yeah? And not just when we want something or something happens, but it should be a lifestyle of all of us, you know, and so on. So we are gathering our prayer requests, and I just want to indulge us. Maybe we can just sing a few times, 505, I need the prayers of those I love, that kind of thing. We're talking about prayer, and we're going to pray in a while, so get your prayer cap together. We're going to try to put it up on the screen and mention, and we're going to spread it up. Kishon, you're going to see short prayers, not long, because we're coming down to the end of the program. Sister Bess, I'm going to invite you also, Pastor Lambert, you know, to also pray. And we want to just lift up those persons who have enjoyed. Maybe we might not be able to take, because while we are praying, requests are still coming in. But God understands. Just by you sending your request, just by you stepping in for somebody, standing in the gap for somebody, even if we might not be able to mention that request by name or the specificity of that request, God also knows that, but he understands that we are praying to him, and he will honor that prayer tonight, you know, as we sing tonight, just maybe a stanza or two, and then we will, you know, just lift up those requests that have been made. 505, I need the prayers of those I love. 505 is the number, yeah? Yeah, tonight, 505.
Prayers of those I love, why traveling on life's rugged way, that I may true and faithful be, and live for Jesus every day. I want my friends to pray for me, to hear my tempted soul above, intercede with God for me. I need the prayers of those I love.
I need
the prayers of those I love to help me in his trying hour, to bear my tempted soul to him, that he may keep me by his power. To pray for me, to bear my tempted soul above, and intercede with God for me. I need the prayers of those I love. I want my friends to pray for me, to hold me up on wings of faith, that I may walk the narrow way, kept by a Father's glorious grace. I want my friends to pray for me, to bear my tempted soul above, and intercede with God for me. I need the prayers of those I love.
Tonight, what a prayer. Maybe I could just run through the list quickly, and we'll just, so because we might not be able to mention all by name, and then we just say a covering prayer for all the requests that have been made. Is that all right?
Yeah
tonight. So tonight we're praying for Rhonda, and we invite you also to join wherever you are as we get ready to pray. And you can also lift up those persons who have indicated. So in prayer, you can lift them up and remember those of our young people. And even as the young people join this week, that God will do a mighty work in their life. So Rhonda Cornwall says, please pray for my brother-in-law, Dean of Healing. All right, so she needs healing, brother-in-law, Dean, for healing. All right. So we're going to pray for that, for healing tonight. Healing is one thing we're going to pray for. Kelly Scott says, pray for my brother in Trinidad who has a broken leg. Again, that's healing and restoration, right? So healing is one of the things. Deborah Stevens says, pray for me and my family, health, strength, and faith. Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
So health and strength and faith. Chomin Bihari says, pray for me and my family and friends. So we're going to pray for families, right? Health or healing and family so far. Dwight McLeish said, please pray for my family. Yeah, so family coming up again, you see. Jenny Williams Plenty says, Sister Plenty from Carico, I hope she says, please pray for my family and I for better health. Right, so you see health coming up again. Health is really a challenge these days. Cheryl Mitchell says, pray for me and my family. So we see family and healing, health coming on. Karina Phillips says, pray for my children and my family, for us to be closer to God at all times, and also my mother and sister to come back to God, continue serving him. So spiritual renewal, revival, connection with God, right? For health. Alvin Philbert says, for health, yeah. Desiree Scott says, pray for my family and I, yeah. So family, health, these are the things coming up. Nelly Salexis, please pray for my family. Giselle Fletcher says, pray for God's protection over me daily to grow in grace as a family, all right? Yeah. So Aldrin says, please pray for me and my family that we be closer drawn to God. Right, so to those who have not yet given their lives to Him, that they will do so. Yeah, so we see family coming up. Yeah, and we want to pray for families, young people, healing, health, closer walk with God. Yeah, those sort of things. Right, so Keyshawn, you're gonna start, and then you say a short prayer, then Lambert, then Bess, and I'll just cover up. Right, short prayers on these prayer emphases. Right, let us pray wherever you are as we bow heads and pray together.
Heavenly Father, we come before your presence, dear Lord, with humbleness in our heart, dear Lord. Understanding that we are weak, we are feeble, dear Lord. But you are great, you are mighty, you are powerful, dear Lord. You are an almighty God, you are the King of kings and Lord of lords, dear Lord. And we just bow low before you, dear Lord. We come, dear Lord, giving you glory and honor and praise, dear Lord. For you deserve all the glory, you deserve all the honor, and you deserve all the praise, O Lord. Dear Lord, we just worship you, dear Lord. We just give you all the praise, dear Lord. Dear Lord, we come humbly, dear Lord, asking, dear Lord, that you heal, dear Lord.
Yes.
We come asking for healing, dear Lord. Amen. Dear Lord, you are the great physician, dear Lord. Amen. You created this body, dear Lord. You know every aspect of this body, dear Lord. Amen. And there is no sickness too hard for you to heal, dear Lord. Dear Lord, you can speak, dear Lord. You can just speak, dear Lord, and it will happen, dear Lord. Dear Lord, speak over this life. Speak over the lives, dear Lord, of all those who is medically challenged, dear Lord. Mm-hmm. All the sick ones, dear Lord. Speak over their lives, dear Lord. Dear Lord, let your will be done over their lives, dear Lord. May they be healed, dear Lord. Dear Lord, we pray for families at this time, dear Lord. Dear Lord, the enemy is attacking families, dear Lord. But dear Lord, we pray for families, dear Lord. Dear Lord, for you created, dear Lord, the family togetherness, dear Lord. Dear Lord, you created that, dear Lord. Dear Lord, and we pray that the families, dear Lord, may look to you, dear Lord.
Yes.
That they might not look to relatives, dear Lord. But that, dear Lord, they might look to you, dear Lord. Any issue they have, dear Lord, they might go down on their knees, dear Lord, and seek you in prayer for direction, dear Lord. Dear Lord, please help them to look to you, dear Lord. Dear Lord, we pray for families, dear Lord. Keep the families together, dear Lord. For when we have a better family, we have a better community, dear Lord. And we have a better country and we have a better
Amen.
World, dear Lord.
Amen.
Dear Lord, please help that the families, dear Lord, may trust in you
Amen.
For everything, dear Lord. They might trust in you for every aspect, dear Lord, and let the love, dear Lord, let the godly love, dear Lord, begin to flow, dear Lord. Let the godly love, dear Lord, be ever present in families, dear Lord. May they be a shining light, dear Lord, to all who they come in contact with, dear Lord. Let your love begin to flow among us, dear Lord. Dear Lord, we pray for those who are strayed, dear Lord, from your word, dear Lord. Dear Lord, please send a conviction spirit, dear Lord. May they be convicted, dear Lord. May they see the darkness, dear Lord, that they're in, dear Lord. And may they run to you, dear Lord, who is light, dear Lord. May they run to you, dear Lord, who is life eternal, dear Lord.
Yes.
And when they may come, may we all be saved in your kingdom in Jesus' most holy and mighty name.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Praise God. Praise God.
Father and God, we continue to petition your throne tonight in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
We give you thanks and praise, O God, for all that transpired here tonight.
Yes.
We thank you for the way that you have worked in our lives so we can testify, and as a result of that, somebody can be encouraged.
Yes.
Amen. Jesus.
In a very special way, O God, we lift up those who are requested their prayers tonight.
Yes.
God.
Especially those who request that they want to be closer to you. We know we're living in a time that is very close to your coming, and we pray that God,
Jesus,
in a very special way,
yes,
that every one of us will make our calling on election sure.
Amen.
I pray, oh God, for the family members who have strayed away from you and those who have not yet accepted you,
yes,
that as they look at the signs that are happening around us, these signs, they are signals, they are telling us that you're about to come. I pray that God, that they will see the importance of totally surrendering their lives to you, so when you shall bust the eastern sky, they can say, "Lo, this is our God. We have waited for him. He is
Amen.
Coming and he will save us."
Amen.
Oh God, continue to bless us and be with us. Guide us and protect us, dear God. And when you come, may each and every one of us be candidates for your kingdom. In Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Heavenly Father, we can search high and we can search low, dear God, but we would never find any that can be compared or likened unto you.
Yes,
but tonight we give you thanks and we give you praise for this fact.
Yes.
Lord, we have seen that there are so many of our youths in the churches, Dwight, Maglish,
Phaedra,
and family, dear God. Lord, they come before you tonight asking for prayers.
Yes,
Jesus.
Families.
We
yes,
know,
dear Lord.
God, that the devil is on the prowl, dear God, and he's coming at them, the God, with such force that sometimes they are not able to stand up. But I pray, Heavenly Father, that you may continue to cover them with your blessing.
Yes, Lord, please.
Yes, Jesus.
Ellen White says that with such an army of youth, right,
God,
I pray that you may continue to speak to their hearts.
Thank you, Jesus.
Help them to make the right decision, the God. We know, the God, that they are in school, the Father. I hope that we would give them the strength that they need, that they would be able to stand up and stand up for you wherever they go, the God. May you continue to help them, the God. As they exercise the little faith day by day, dear God.
Yes.
May you come through for them in such a powerful way, dear
Father.
Yes,
Lord. Thank
you,
Jesus.
Heavenly Father, that you may continue to deliver them, dear Father.
Yes, please.
We know, Lord Jesus, that they cannot do it on their own strength, dear Father. But I ask you, Lord, that you may continue to guide, to direct, the God, the choices of music, the clothes that they wear, and so on, dear God. Oh, Lord, come through for them in such
Hallelujah.
A mighty way, oh, Lord
Hallelujah.
Jesus. I also pray, dear God, for the youths of Snail Hall, dear God. You know that there are so many of them that are in the valley of decision, wavering between you and Satan, oh Lord. I pray that you may cover them, Lord Jesus.
Yes, hallelujah.
Cover them, oh Lord. Cover them, oh Lord. Cover them day and night, Lord Jesus. And I pray, dear God, that as they look at us, dear God, they may see you high and lifted up.
Amen.
Them that they would continue to trust, dear God. And as they trust you, oh Lord Jesus, that you would come true for them, oh Lord.
Amen.
I thank you so much for what you have done for them thus far and will continue to do in their lives.
Mm-hmm.
And whatever you see that we all stand in need of, I pray that you may continue to grant it unto us this day. We pray in Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen. Father, we thank you for tonight. We thank you for giving us the opportunity to talk to you and to minister on this program. All the prayer requests that have been made and even those that have come in while we are praying, we pray, God, that you look down in a very special way and touch and deliver and heal and bless and restore your people. May they experience your power. May they move and turn their hearts to you, dear Heavenly Father. We pray that you continue to do that. We pray that you bless the panelists here as they have testified. Lord, you are still working on them. Thank you for what you've done. Continue to continue that great work that you have begun. And we pray, dear Heavenly Father, for our young people and all of our adults as we join together in this upcoming week of prayer, that, Lord, indeed, we will experience a revival. Indeed, we will experience your mighty hand and upon our lives. We thank you again for hearing and answering our prayers. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Amen.
And
amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Well, folks, thank you very much. And we thank you for being with us tonight on another episode of Adventist Youth Live. This program comes to you from the Greater Conference of Seventh-day Adventists, of course, a combination with the Youth Ministries Department and the Communication Department. And on behalf of the producers and all the guys behind the scene, the technical guys, we thank you very, very much. Panelists, thank you very much. And we look forward to seeing you next week at 7:30 when we will have another episode of Adventist Youth Live. All for now, God bless you and enjoy the rest of the Sabbath. God bless.
Share your love and grace in all I do. Lord, I come before you with contrite heart. Humbly I surrender all that I am. I want to learn from you. Please draw me close to you. Let me share your love and grace in all I do. Oh Lord, transform me. Change my heart completely to be more like you. Oh Lord, renew me. Heal my mind and broken heart today. I want to be and to do what you commanded. And be filled with the Spirit every day. To serve you wherever you may lead me. I want to serve you till the very end. Oh Lord, transform me. Change my heart completely to be more like you. Oh Lord, renew me. Heal my mind and broken heart today. Shine a light to a darkened world, and always live your truth in every way. May your love for me be seen by everyone, and lead others to trust the love you want.